Okay, good afternoon students. Today I will explain reciprocal vectors. Reciprocal vectors. The concept of reciprocal vectors. If A bar, comma B bar, comma C bar or non-coplanar vectors, then B bar cross C by box ABC, C bar cross A bar by box ABC, A bar cross B bar by box ABC are known as reciprocal vectors of A bar comma B bar comma C bar. These three vectors are known as this is the reciprocal vector of A bar, this is the reciprocal vector of B bar, and this is the reciprocal vector of C bar. So these three vectors are said to be reciprocal vectors of A bar, B bar, C bar respectively. Since the dot product of these vectors A bar dot B cross C by box A bar, B bar, C bar. That means once you take the dot product of A bar and its reciprocal vector, we get A bar dot B cross C by box ABC, which is box ABC by ABC itself, A bar, B bar, C bar itself. Hence that is 1. That means the product of these two vectors is 1. Hence this is said to be reciprocal vector of A bar. Similarly, B bar dot C bar cross A bar by box ABC is B bar dot C bar cross A bar by box ABC itself. Here box ABC is a scalar. So the dot product is executed between these two vectors. Hence, this is box BCA by box ABC itself, which is also 1. And similarly, the dot product of C bar and A cross B by box ABC gives us C bar dot A bar cross B bar by box A bar, B bar, C bar itself. That is box CAB by box ABC. These two are equal, hence it is 1. Hence the dot product of ABC and these vectors is 1. Therefore, these vectors are said to be reciprocal vectors of A bar, B bar, C bar respectively. Let it be this is P, this is Q, this is R. Once taking these A dash, B dash, C dash vectors, these three are said to be reciprocal vectors of the given vectors, non-coplanar vectors A bar, B bar, C bar. Let P bar equal to B cross C by box ABC. Q bar equal to C cross A by box ABC. R bar equal to A bar cross B bar by box ABC. B reciprocal vectors of non-coplanar vectors A bar, B bar, C bar because once they are non-coplanar, the box value is not equal to 0. Hence, the denominator is not equal to 0 here. So, the non-coplanar vectors A bar, B bar, C bar respectively, then the first one, box, what about box P bar, Q bar, R bar? The once P bar is defined as B cross C by box ABC, Q bar is defined as C bar cross A bar by box ABC, R bar is defined as A bar cross B bar by box ABC. Then what about the value of box ABC, box P, Q, R? That is equal to here box B cross C by, sorry, B cross C by box ABC, C cross A by box ABC, A cross B by box ABC. This is one vector, this is one vector, this is one vector. This is a scalar, this is a scalar, this is a scalar. The scalars involved in the box value may be taken common. Taken common from the box value, we get 1 by box ABC cube. From this term, you can take this scalar common. From this term, you can take the scalar common. From this term, you can take 1 by box ABC as common. In such case, 1 by box ABC whole cube into box B cross C, C cross A, A cross C. Okay? But we know that box B cross C, C cross A cross B. Box B cross C, C cross A cross B is the box value is box ABC whole square itself, already known to you. It is already given to you. Box B cross C, C cross A cross B is always equal to box ABC square. Hence, you get 1 by box ABC. So, once P, Q, R, be the reciprocal vectors, of 3 non-coplanar vectors A bar, B bar, C bar, then their box value is 1 by box of ABC. From this, we can conclude that, therefore, we can say that box of reciprocal vectors and box of given vectors, product of these boxes is always equal to 1, That is one important concept. Next one, the second property of reciprocal vectors. If P bar, Q bar, R bar of B reciprocal vectors, then A bar dot P bar plus B bar dot Q bar plus C bar dot R bar value. The dot product of given non-coplanar vectors with their reciprocal vectors respectively are considered here, and sum of the dot products is A bar dot B cross C by box A bar, B bar, C bar plus B bar dot C bar cross A by box A bar, B bar, C bar, C bar dot A cross B by box A, B, C itself. Clearly, this is box A bar, B bar, C bar by box A, B, C. Because A dot B cross C may be written as box ABC. Similarly, this is box BCA by box ABC. this is similarly box CAB by box AB. These are also in cyclic order, BCA, CAB, hence which is equal to box ABC itself, hence 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. A dot P plus B dot Q plus C dot R is always equal to 3 here. This is one important concept related to the reciprocal vectors. Next, the third point related to this one. Let us consider the cross product of A bar cross B bar plus B bar cross Q bar plus C bar cross R bar. The cross product of three non-coplanar vectors with their corresponding reciprocal vectors is considered sum of such cross products. Here this is equal to A bar cross, this is B cross C by box ABC itself. Box ABC is a scalar, plus B bar cross C cross A by box ABC itself. C bar cross A bar cross B bar by box ABC itself. Okay. You can take one by box ABC throughout this cross product. So, one by box ABC into taking that scalar in the denominator as common, we get A bar cross B cross C. This is the first term. B cross C cross A, second term. C cross A cross B, third term. It comes under vector triple product. So, the vector triple product may be evaluated through dot product. This vector triple product may be written as A dot C multiplied B bar minus A dot B multiplied C bar, this value. Similarly, B dot A multiplied C bar, B dot A multiplied C bar minus B dot C multiplied A bar. Similarly, the vector triple product C bar cross A bar cross B bar is C dot B multiplied A minus C dot A multiplied B. By vector triple product A cross B cross C is A dot C multiplied B minus A dot B multiplied C. Similarly, other. Now on simplification, 1 by box ABC into, now A dot C B bar, similarly C dot A bar. A dot C is same that of C dot A. These scalars are equal, so sum K into B bar minus K into B bar, so hence these two terms cancel. Similarly, minus A dot B into C, B dot A into C is one and the same, so cancel. Similarly, this one is cancel. Since these are all vectors, sum of the vectors is a vector itself. Hence, since these are all vectors, scalar multiples of vectors, so that is once by cancellation we get 0 bar. The resultant is 0 because the resultant is 0. 0 bar by some constant is 0 bar itself. So, therefore, A bar cross P bar plus B bar cross Q bar plus R bar cross, C bar, C bar cross R bar is always equal to 0 bar. Once P bar, Q bar, R bar be the reciprocal vectors of ABC, then A cross P plus B cross Q plus C cross R is always equal to 0. Such points are very important points related to this reciprocal vectors. Reciprocal vectors. Next one. Next, the problem is like this. If P bar, Q bar, R bar be reciprocal vectors, reciprocal vectors of non-coplanar vectors, non-coplanar vectors, then find P bar dot A bar plus P plus Q bar dot B bar plus C R bar dot A bar C bar plus A bar. A bar dot P bar dot A bar plus B bar, Q bar dot B bar plus C bar, plus R bar dot C bar plus A bar value. Here P bar dot A bar plus B bar. Let us consider the first term here. Here that the first term P bar dot A bar plus B bar is. P bar is reciprocal vectors of non-coplanar vectors A bar, B bar, C bar, of course, respectively. Respectively. Then find this one. Okay. P bar, Q bar, R bar be reciprocal vectors of non-coplanar vectors A bar, B bar, C bar respectively. Then the dot product sum. So for that consider the first term P bar dot A bar plus B bar. Since P bar is reciprocal vector of A bar, hence B cross C by box ABC dot A bar plus B bar. This is a scalar, so take the scalar out of the product at first. Let us consider the dot product of these two vectors with this one, because dot is distributed with respect to vector addition. So hence, assuming B cross C as a vector, taking dot product, the dot product is distributive. Hence you can write it as B cross C dot A plus B cross C dot B. This is 1 by box A, B, C into, this is B, C, A box value plus B, C, B box value. In any box value, scalar triple product, if two vectors are equal or parallel, then the box value is 0, hence this is 0 clearly. So that is 1 by box A, B, C to box B, C, A plus 0 itself. This value is 0. B, C, A is same to that of A, B, C. Box B, C, A by A, B, C, box A, B, C. Since these are in cyclic order only, the value is 1. Similarly, by cyclic order, similarly, Q bar dot B bar plus C bar is 1 and R bar dot C bar plus A bar is also 1. Therefore, sum of the dot terms of the dot product here, Q bar dot B bar plus C bar plus R bar dot C bar plus A bar is always equal to 3. This is 1, this is 1, this is 1. So, hence 3. the required value is 3. Like that, different problems may set on these reciprocal vectors. Okay. These are all related to vector triple products, which are useful in objective examinations. Next problem. If A bar, B bar, C bar are 3 coterminal edges, if A bar, B bar, C bar are 3 coterminal edges of a parallelopiped, whose volume is V, then the volume of tetrahedron whose coterminal edges are B cross C by box A, B, C. C cross A by box A, B, C. A cross B by box A, B, C. Is that. That is V by 6, 6V. This is six by V, both cannot be determined. Okay. If A bar, B bar, C bar are 3 coterminal edges of a parallelopiped of volume V, then volume of tetrahedron whose coterminal edges are B cross C by box ABC, C cross A by box ABC, A cross B by box ABC is. Here volume of the parallelopiped V equal to modulus of box A bar, B bar, C bar. V equal to volume of the parallelepiped is given by modulus of box ABC itself. Let it be 1. Now, volume of tetrahedron, having B cross C by V, because this is V, I am taking it as a V, taking positively, we can take it as V, otherwise box, take this one, box. Finally, you can take the modulus value. Volume of tetrahedron having these vectors as coterminal edges. Coterminal edges equal to 1/6 of their box value. Box B cross C by box A, B, C. C cross A by box A, B, C. A cross B by box ABC, box where with modulus. That is 1/6 of modulus of, actually this is this one is 1/6 into 1/6 box ABC whole cube into box modulus of box B cross C, C cross A, A cross with modulus. Of course, taking this one also in modulus. Box BC, B cross C, C cross A, A cross B is box ABC itself whole square by 6 into box ABC whole cube with modulus, which is 1/6V. Let it be 1/6V. So that you can take one option as 1/6V. The required volume of the tetrahedron is obtained by 1/6V itself. Like that you can apply the reciprocal vectors. This is reciprocal vector PQR. Box PQR is 1/box ABC. This is 1/box ABC. So 1/6 into 1/box ABC. Box ABC is 1V. Hence that is 1/6V is the required volume. Such simple applications may be applied to this reciprocal vectors. Okay. So these are all the different concepts of vector. Vector triple product. Now, this is one important concept. Perpendicular distance from fixed point AA bar to the line R bar equal to some C bar plus lambda D. Perpendicular distance from a fixed point AA bar to the line R bar equal to C bar plus lambda D bar. This is our concept. Let us consider three dimensional line which passes through the point C bar. The position vector of a fixed point on the line is C bar and parallel to the vector D bar. Now you have to find the perpendicular distance from the point fixed point A to this line, three-dimensional line, whose equation is given as R bar equal to C bar plus lambda D bar. That means you have to find AM here, the perpendicular distance. For that, join this one. To get this one, this AM is nothing but orthogonal projection of CA in this direction. That is one way of finding AM bar or MA bar. This is the orthogonal projection of CA in the perpendicular direction of D bar. That gives us AM. That is one way of obtaining AM. So AM bar here. AM bar equal to CM plus AM, MA, otherwise do one thing, MA. We will take MA. CM plus MA is CA bar. So MA bar equal to CA bar minus CM bar. In position vectors, this is OA bar minus OC bar minus CM bar is the projection of vector component of otherwise. Projection or vector component. Vector component of CA bar along D bar. The vector component of CA bar along D bar. This is A bar minus C bar minus vector component of CA bar along D bar is CA bar dot D bar by modulus of D bar. That is A bar minus C bar minus A bar minus C bar dot D bar by mod D bar itself. This is vector component. Vector component means again D bar by modulus of D bar. Of course, this is only gives a scalar component. That means CM itself. Now we are in need of CM bar. Hence, I am taking CM multiplied by unit vector in that direction. So, by D bar by modulus of D. Which gives us A bar minus C bar into mod D bar square multiplying these two minus A bar minus C bar dot D bar multiplied D bar by mod D bar square. Mod D bar square is D dot D. That is A bar minus C bar into D dot D minus A bar minus C bar dot D multiplied D bar, okay, by modulus of D bar. This may be written as D bar cross A bar minus C bar cross D bar by modulus of D bar square. D dot D multiplied A bar minus C bar, this one, minus D dot A minus C multiplied D bar by modulus of D. So the perpendicular distance the vector along the perpendicular distance MA bar is given by D bar cross A bar minus C bar cross D bar by modulus of D square. The denominator is scalar. This is completely a vector. This product is obtained by this one. So MA is modulus of this one cross A bar minus C bar cross D bar by mod D bar square. This is one way of finding the required perpendicular distance from a fixed point A bar to the line whose equation is given by R bar equal to C bar plus lambda D bar. The magnitude of this vector, gives us the perpendicular distance MA. This is one way of finding the, or the second method is, or in case of second method is, we know that taking the cross product of these two, sine theta of course here, let be this is theta, taking sine theta here, from the figure sine theta equal to, sin theta equal to MA by CA. So MA takes the value CA sin theta. C CA bar, CA means modulus of CA into sine theta. CA bar is modulus of A bar minus C bar into sine of angle between these two. So this can be written as, modulus of CA bar and of course modulus of D bar. The angle between CA and D is theta, hence I am taking modulus of D bar sine theta by modulus of D bar. I am multiplying the numerator and denominator with modulus of D. Now this can be written as, modulus of CA bar cross D bar by mod D bar. By definition of the cross product, this may be written as CA bar cross D bar by mod D bar. On evaluation of either this or this, we get the same MA itself. This is very simple process, very easy process. CA bar cross D bar with modulus, the cross product of CA and D gives us mod CA bar, mod D bar and sine of angle between CA and D, D and CA otherwise. Taking that modulus, you need not take n cap, okay. So that MA takes the value modulus of CA bar cross D bar by modulus of D bar itself. This is one important procedure of finding the perpendicular distance from fixed point to the given line whose vector form is R bar equal to C bar plus lambda D bar. The perpendicular distance from the fixed point to the line. In Cartesian form, let us consider in Cartesian form. Cartesian form of the line is given. If the line is given in Cartesian form, suppose A is x1, y1, z1 and the line is given by x minus x2 by A1, y minus y2 by B1, z minus z2 by C1. Then perpendicular distance from A to the line, the perpendicular distance from A to the line is modulus of the determinant ijk and D bar, the parallel vector to this line, a1 b1 c1 into CA bar is C is the point x2 y2 z2, A is the point x1 y1 z1, CA bar is some x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. Once you evaluate this determinant, we get a vector, the modulus of that vector by modulus of D bar. That means square root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square itself. Evaluation of that vector, evaluation of this vector and taking the modulus, we get the perpendicular distance from the given point to the line. From this one, we can evaluate in Cartesian form also.